Hello, my loves. Thank you so much for joining me here at Kara's Love Techniques. I am Kara. I thank you so much for joining me today. Be sure to like and subscribe and also check me out on Twitter and Instagram. Okay? So today we're talking about being an empath and dating. All right? So for those of you who may not know exactly what an empath is, being an empath is someone who is very sensitive to others' energy. So much so they can feel what others feel on a more intense level, to the point to where you can almost read what it is that they're thinking. So it's one of those things where it's a blessing and a curse all at the same time. You know, it does have its pros and cons, which is what I want to speak on today. So if you are an empath and you sort of have challenges with dating, or you may not know exactly how to go about, you know, what it is you should do during the dating process because of your, of how you feel. And being an empath myself, I completely understand. I actually learned that I was an empath just a couple years ago and did a little research, and wow. Okay, so just want to share some of the pros and cons. So some of the pros of being, you know, an empath is it does allow you to have your heart open regardless of what you've gone through in the past. You have a big heart. You are willing and ready to care, to share love. You're open, and that's a great thing, okay? So you're not as reluctant to just, you're not reluctant to change or any sort of newness. You are just ready to go with the flow. You know, you're ready. You're not apprehensive at all. And the second thing is, the good thing is you can pick up on someone's energy, especially if it's very positive, you know, if they are a good candidate for you, or, you know, whatever it is that they're feeling, you can kind of pick up on that and interpret how your next few dates are going to be. You know, you have a strong intuition of what's to come. So having a strong intuition, and especially if you're very intuned intuitively, you know, you kind of make the right decisions. When you listen to your gut feeling, you know, you basically determine what's going to happen that's based on what you're feeling, whereas many people don't listen to their instincts, okay? And so the next thing is you also know about those red flags. If when someone's speaking and you can kind of determine what's going to be stated next and it doesn't sound quite right, okay, so that's a red flag. You have a great keen sense and an ability to just to pick out what red flags are, whereas many people are just totally oblivious to what a red flag is, you know. And one other thing is being able to discern someone's character and their behavior just in a moment, within a matter of minutes. That's a blessing, whereas it could take people months before they actually learn an individual or really tap down into their someone's deeper, you know, soul, into their deeper self. And being an empath, you feel all of that instantly, you know. It's instant. So you can kind of discern, you know, what's going to be with this person. Is he or she needy? Are they manipulative? Whatever their character is, you can kind of just like pick that right out immediately. However, some of the cons to being an empath and dating is being attracted to all types of people, and usually the attraction that comes your way are those who are brokenhearted or need some sort of fixing. They need to be healed in some way. And that's a challenging thing, because now you have to determine rather or not, you know, hey, this is a good-hearted person, you know, decent as far as people go. Now, do I really want to be in this individual's life and help mend their broken heart and show them what, you know, real care and real love is? Is that really my job? You know, so that's one thing that you have to decide upon. Do I really need this? Again, you know, wanting to help someone else or show them what real affection and real love is, that sort of thing. And next, giving more to the other person, healing more, you know, caring more for them than they are for you. So you may put out far more energy and far more effort into this new situation than what you're getting back. You know, so there's that imbalance of give and take. And that's another thing. It's like, okay, should I pull away and have some sort of major effect on this person? That's another obstacle. And one other thing is when you're in this sort of situation, it can cause a great deal of anxiety, stress, because it's not really something that you were looking for. So ultimately, it comes down to just determining what it is that you need for yourself. Okay? This is a time to where you have to be a little selfish and say, well, I'm looking for love. You know, you're going to have to determine if you're trying to heal someone or love someone. You can do both, but it's draining. It is exhausting. So to try to heal someone and be there for someone who was brokenhearted and continuously show and prove yourself that, hey, I'm not going to hurt you, it can be a bit exhausting. But a solution to that is if you really want to be with that individual, well, then you should probably recommend or suggest some sort of counseling for them outside of your relationship. You know, speaking with a healer, someone who can help them be with you in a more positive manner. This way, your role in the relationship is just simply to be a partner, a significant other. And you don't have to be burdened down with doing both, you know, because that's usually the challenge. And when you don't know how to do that, it can be very stressful. It really can. And it's like, I don't want to leave this person because they maybe become more damaged. So it's kind of like an uphill battle in a sense if you don't know how to handle it. And for those of you who are dating someone who's an empath, you kind of have to be very understanding, because if they express themselves to you in a way, and they're not doing it intentionally to just be combative, it's because of what they're feeling. It's the energy that they're picking up. And in order to get that emotion, that feeling, that intensity to dissipate, that empath has to release in some way. They have to express themselves, because otherwise it can become very, very overwhelming to the point it can lead you into depression if you don't know how to channel your energy and your emotions as an empath. So if you are dating someone who is an empath, you kind of have to just understand that when they express themselves, it's just to kind of understand why they're expressing themselves, or they have a major concern that needs to be addressed like immediately. Okay, so it could be a little challenging being an empath and trying to date, especially today, because there's so much out there. You know, as I've told you all once before, I attract all types of people. I attract everybody. Like, it's, yes, I mean, I just want to go to the grocery store, stand in line, and just check out without having any dialogue and just be peace, because my world is centered around people, helping people, you know, that sort of thing. So there's moments to where you're going to need your space. And that's another thing. If you're dating someone who's an empath, they are going to need that quiet time, that space, because when you're out into the world, especially if you have a career that interacts with people, you have interpersonal relationships on a daily basis, it's draining because now you're picking up all of this energy and you're carrying it with you. So having that alone time, I mean, a great deal of amount of alone time is necessary. Okay. Yes, I learned that long time ago, even before I knew I was an empath, that I have to be by myself and just going someplace quiet, like to a beach, just picking out your own little area and just sending, just letting it all out. You have to. Okay, so you kind of have to know how to channel this sort of energy, how to bring it in and then release it. Okay, but dating isn't all that bad if you know how to go about doing it. You just, you know, just one person at a time. Each case may be different. You know, you may just end up with someone who just have nothing but positive energy, may not need to be healed, but just need someone to be there for them. And that's good. That's like the best thing ever, right? Yeah. Okay, my loves, I just thought I'd share for all of my empaths and healers out there in the world. Yeah, so until next time, my loves.